Should having an affair preclude a man from running for office?
I think that if...
Because if that was the case, then there'd be no JFK, there'd be no Bill Clinton, there'd be no Newt Gingrich. I mean, there'd be lots of people who have been at the top of American political life who would simply never have careers. So where do you draw the line?
Well, I think that politicians, if they are going to seek the highest office in our land, the presidency of the United States of America, they need to be honest with the American public and just put it all out there. And not be hypocrites, not present themselves as the perfect family man. If they've played around, if they've had affairs, just put it out there, and the public will decide whether they think it matters or not.
Newt Gingrich has now been pretty open and said, look, this is all in my past. I'm married now for the third time. I'm very happy. I'm a changed man. Are you happy with that? Are you happy for him to restart politically, if you like?
Well, let me just say, I mean, I'm not a person who's going to vote for any of the potential Republican nominees for the presidency of the United States, but not for those reasons. For the reason that they are against the right to choose abortion, and I believe that women must have safe and legal and available abortions in this country, and I'm not going to be willing to go back to the days when states had a right to criminalize abortion. And right now, we've got like 88% almost of all of the counties in the United States. A woman can't even get an abortion, even though it is legal, because of all the harassment of doctors, the harassment of the clinics, the threats that are made against them, the constant restrictions that certain legislatures are placing on a woman's right to choose abortion. That hurts the poor. It hurts the young. And it's just absolutely wrong. So I can't support any of those potential nominees for that reason. And also because they're not willing to say that gays and lesbians should enjoy marriage equality. And that is an affront to their dignity. It is an affront to the respect that gay and lesbian individuals have a right to enjoy, to say they should have some other status, like civil unions, rather than full equality. I mean, we fought in our law firm for 6 years in the California courts, and we won a case in the California Supreme Court. And as a result of another case that we argued in the Supreme Court, 14,000 couples were permitted, gay and lesbian couples, permitted to marry in California. So I'm against all those Republican nominees because they won't afford equal rights.
I have a shocking thing to tell you. I agree with you.